There's so much Nexus stuff we could talk about, but I want to transition on to Bad News Barrett, which was great in its own right, because when I found out that you were going to be on the show, I instantly thought of this unbelievably wonderful clip from the 2014 WWE Hall of Fame. Let's please take a look.
Now, tonight, of course, is the night that we all get together to honor those superstars who've had incredible careers. And we put them in the WWE Hall of Fame. But I'm afraid I've got some bad news. Because as I look out before me at a bunch of so-called superstars, I want you all to take a piece of advice from me. Remember this moment. Remember this feeling. Drink it all in. Because mark my words, this is the closest that any of you pathetic wannabes will ever get to the WWE Hall of Fame. Thank you very much.
It's still wonderful.
I love that so much. I have a few questions off that. How did that come about? It was the Hall of Fame. Very rare that something like that would happen. And do you think that's the perfect snapshot of the Bad News Barrett character, which obviously I got its start on the JBL and Cole show? To me, that was prime Bad News Barrett right there, 2014 Hall of Fame.
Yeah, I'd say that Bad News Barrett moment was the moment Bad News Barrett took off. I'd been doing the Bad News Barrett kind of character and persona for about 1 or 2 months at that point on various Raws and SmackDowns. And it was slowly gaining a little traction with the fans. That was the night it completely took off. And that was the promo really that solidified Bad News Barrett as somebody who's going to be a player in the next few months in WWE. So yeah, I agree with you. That was a great moment. And as an encapsulation of a Bad News Barrett promo, that's as good as any. It kind of came out of the blue. I was expecting to be at the Hall of Fame in the crowd as usual, sat there watching the show. As we know, the Hall of Fame can be a little slow at times. It tends to be a 3 or 4 hour event. Very exciting stuff, but after you've watched 3 or 4 hours of speeches, especially reminiscing on careers and stuff like that, it can get a little dry. So I think Vince McMahon came up with the idea of adding a little bit of excitement at some point in the show to break it up a bit. And he came to me and wanted me involved. Thankfully, it all came off well. And that was the moment after that Vince saw the reaction to that, saw how well that promo had gone. And the very next Raw, which would have been probably 2 nights later, after the Hall of Fame, I was in the ring with Rey Mysterio and wrestling Rey Mysterio on Raw, unfortunately for me, beating him. So Bad News Barrett was off to a great in-ring start after that.
I was just wondering, because it's been a while and we haven't seen you and you're doing commentary. The thing, there was this thing you said.
Hall of Fame, 2014.
Let's just pretend you're on a scissor lift right now on the bump. Did you have any final words or messages to the WWE Universe that they may not have heard for a while?
Yeah, let me tell you something, WWE Universe, it has been fantastic being on the bump today, but you know what? I'm afraid I've got some bad news. I am a busy man, and I have 100 things to do, and I cannot spend the rest of my day talking to you. So it's time for me to hang up and get back to my life.
Hey, okay. I'm so happy about
snap back in very easily. It's always there. It's always up the sleeve when I need it.